Fish and Game called me. We have a black bear that was hit on the Florida Turnpike.
From his home, the Everglades Outpost, Freer has worked for over 25 years policing and rescuing Miami's native animals. He knows it's unusual for a bear to be so far out of its regular territory.
I woke up like that once there was a bear call. You know, just threw my clothes on and I forgot. I hadn't even told my wife where I was going. I was almost out the bedroom door and she goes, "So, where are you going?"
Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission Lieutenant Pat Reynolds is already at the scene and has managed to track down and tranquilize the bear.
I basically just drove up with my window down and the dart gun and just shot him with the dart, and he ran off over here and he needed one more dart. It's starting to stir a little bit. It's been an hour since the tranquilizer's been in him.
I could see a gash on his right rear leg. I'm not sure, maybe that was from, probably if he was hit by a car.
Half sedated, the bear is wandering close to the freeway, putting itself and the night's travelers in danger. Freer and Reynolds need to move it to a safe area to assess its injured leg.
Kind of good.
The bear is small, but even at this size, it can inflict a devastating injury. Freer has to approach with caution as he tries to administer another sedative.
A little mired down here in mud.
It is a deep wound.
158 bears were killed on Florida's roads last year. As the city limits encroach further into their natural territory, bear encounters are likely to become more frequent as they're pushed ever further into urban areas.
Okay.
Darts were out. Man.
A young male here, and just took a look at his gums, checking to see if it's a little bit anemic, parasites or something. No, he's actually looks quite healthy.
This is extremely exciting and highly unusual that the bear would end up here. It's a long ways from out in the Big Cypress, through the sawgrass of the Everglades, all the way over here to a very urbanized area.
Now we need to pretty much get to the outpost as soon as we can, because we don't want him waking up with that anesthesia wearing off and just be in the van with him. All right, thanks again, Bob.
No problem.
Catch you again.
Appreciate it.
Freer heads back to his wildlife sanctuary, where the bear will be kept until morning. Tomorrow, he'll be taken to a wildlife vet, where his fate will be determined.